Guys, welcome to my second class of Gram's committee process. In the previous video is not allowed after 20 minutes in my video. Already I discussed this problem, second problem. Use Gram's committee process to find out orthonormal basis, the vectors are x1, x2, x3. I explained in my previous video up to finding v1, v2, v3. I think everyone is clear how to find out v1, v2, v3 using Gram's committed process, the formula. Once we get v1, v2, v3, next I have to find out what happened in a product of the mutual vectors, must be 0. Then only say that that is orthogonal set. Therefore, inner product of v1 comma v2. V1 comma v2 is nothing but inner v1 transpose into v2, multiply that, we get 0. Similarly, I have to take inner product of v1 comma v3. Then you multiply that row into column, we get 0. And also I have to take inner product of v2 v3, means v2 transpose into v3, we get 0. This shows that we can't write simply 0. This is your cross check, what you find out v1, v2, v3 are correct or not from the Gram's committed method. You please try to understand, don't do any game here. Even though sometimes we get v2, v2, v3, but inner product of v1, v2, v2, v3, v1, v3 is not equal to 0, you are writing 0, you are going to lose the marks. Keep in mind, suppose you don't get it inner product of any mutual inner product value is not equal to 0, then we say that these vectors are not orthogonal set. Then maybe you've done somewhere mistake to find out the values of v1, v2, v3. Please check it out once again. Maybe usually you are a human being, then maybe you are doing any mistake. Even though plus or minus sign also very, very important. Takes care. Keep in mind, this is your cross check. Then easy to say that I get a marks for this because then your orthogonal, this is a inner product of v1, v2, v3 must be 0. This is also another cross check where to remember. Now sometimes what happens, students, you don't, even though don't get it the value, simply writing 0. Don't do like that. That suppose you don't get it, once again check the finding the values of v1, v2, v3 using Gram's committed method. Maybe done somewhere mistake, you correct it, we get a correct answer. Then we say that v1, v2, v3 are orthogonal. And also, v1, v2, v3, we know very clear, are non-zero vectors. Therefore, then one of the result you already known that in other videos, after orthogonal set, whenever v1, v2, v3 is a non-zero orthogonal set of any basis, then we say that it's a non-zero orthogonal set is a basis, is a linearly independent and also form a basis. We already discussed, we already proved that result. Hence, v1, comma the set of vector v1, comma v2, v3 is a orthogonal basis for W of a subspace of R cube. I think clear. I'm moving to the next different type of problem. Now, we discussed for previous first and second problem how to find out orthogonal, orthogonal basis. But here, how to find out orthonormal basis? Now, apply the Gram's committed orthogonalization process to find the orthonormal basis for the subspace of Euclidean space with dimension 3 spanned by the vectors are x1, x2, x3. Now, as usual, up to orthogonal basis, we have to do it same thing. First, we have to find the vectors v1, v2 and v3 are the corresponding vectors of x1, x2 and x3 by using Gram's committed process. From the Gram's committed process, first you write the formula v1. What is v1 is x1 only. What is v2? X2 minus orthogonal projection of x2 on v1. V3 is nothing but x3 minus orthogonal projection of x3 on v1, orthogonal projection of x3 on v2. Then this is these two formula we have to substitute. Now, what are the values are required? You find out from the given. V1 is equal to x1, you know that. Then if you want to find out this value, first you find out which value now? Inner product of x2 comma v1. You know how to find out inner product of x2 comma v1. This is a column, therefore I take an x2 transpose into v1. Yeah, and also find out inner product of v1 comma v1. Yeah, is v1 transpose into v1. then we get this value. Similarly, now I have to substitute these values. Where I'm going to substitute? In the formula, x2, you know that what's the value they given x2. X2 is what? Minus 1, 1, 0. Minus this value 0 divided by 3. When entire this value 0, what we get? Minus 1, 1, 0. Yeah, this is V2. Similarly, I have to find out V3 means what are the values are I'm going to find out inner product of X3, V1 and inner product of X3, V2 and inner product of V2, V2 because you already know that inner product of V1, V1. That one you know how to find out. Then is X3 transpose of V1. This is nothing but X3 transpose of V2. So row, transpose means row, column become row. Multiply that, we get these are the values. Once we get these values, where I'm going to substitute? In the formula of V3. X3 is what actually 1, 2, 1 minus inner product of X3, V1 and we calculated 4 divided by inner product of V1, V1 is 3. And then into V1 minus half how we get inner product of X3, V2 is 1 and inner product of V2, V2 is nothing but what we get actually V2, V2 is 2. And then substitute these values simplify it. We get which value? V3 value we get. Once we get V3 value, you know how to see. I'm little bit fast, don't feel bad because I already explained two problems. This is a third problem. Once we get these values, then we have to check what happened in a product of V1, V2, V2, V3 and V1, V3. Then in all three cases we get zero. Then we say that these V1, V2, V3 are orthogonal and also non-zero vector because all are non-zero vectors only. These vectors is a non-zero orthogonal set of a subspace of our Euclidean space with dimension 3. Therefore, we know that non-zero orthogonal set is a basis. Hence, V1, V2, V3 is an orthogonal basis for the subspace of Euclidean space with the dimension. What's the dimension of this Euclidean space is 3. Next, here they are not asking orthogonal basis, they are asking orthonormal basis. You have to normalize. Normalize means each of the vector I have to divide by the corresponding length of the vector, corresponding normal vector value. Therefore, first you calculate what is norm of V1. What is the norm of V1? Square root of V1, we already known that square root of this is actually V1 value. Okay, square root of 1 square plus 1 square plus 1 square, what we get? Root 3. Similarly, I have to calculate norm of V2. Square root of minus 1 whole square plus 1 square plus 0 square, we get root 2. Similarly, I have to calculate norm of V3, square root of 1 by 6 whole square plus 1 by 6 whole square minus 1 by 3 whole square. Simplify that, finally we get 1 by root 6. From that, what is my U1? V1 by norm of V1, divide by V1 by 1 by root 3, we get this. U2 is nothing but V2 divided by norm of V2. Then we get, take that division value inside, we get this. And similarly, U3 is nothing but V3 divided by norm of V3. You take division, the value of V3 inside, we get this. This is a square root of minus of square root of 2 by 3. Square root having more, both numerator and denominator. Don't try, this is a normal set. The orthonormal set. You already know that is orthonormal set means it must be satisfied. Two conditions. What are the two conditions? These U1, U2, U3 are must be mutual. Inner products, inner product value must be 0. But length of the each of the vector must be 1. Means inner product of U1, U1, U2, U2, U3, U3 must be 1. First you calculate in a mutual inner product U1, U2 is nothing but U1 transpose U2. Then you have U1, U2, U3 we calculated just now. You multiply that, in all the three cases we get 0. Therefore, these U1, U2, U3 are orthogonal. But I want to verify is orthonormal means length of the each of the vector must be 1. Means norm of U1 I want to calculate. Norm of U1 means what actually inner product of U1, U1. You already know that what's the definition of orthonormal set. inner product of ui comma uj is equal to 0 for I is not equal to j, equal to 1, I is equal to j. Now I have to calculate what happened inner product of u1 comma u1. u1 transpose of u1, we are expecting 1. Inner product of u2 comma u2, we are expecting a 1. Inner product of u3 comma u3, we are expecting 1. You know how to multiply, that's why I am skipping that. u3 transpose of which value? U3 transpose of u3. Yes. Then we say that u1, u2, u3 is an, we satisfy the condition, both the condition of the orthonormal set. Therefore, is an orthonormal set. Therefore, is an orthonormal basis for the subspace of R3. Are you clear? This is orthonormal set. Therefore, is an orthonormal basis. Now, if you, this is a difference between orthogonal basis, orthonormal. Orthogonal basis is just you find out inner product of v1, v2, v3, then we say the orthogonal basis. If you want to show that orthonormal basis, further you find out u1, u2, u3, v1 is nothing but v1 divided by length of the corresponding vector. That's why we find out u1, u2, u3. You verify that whether that u1, u2, u3 are orthogonal, and also inner product to itself is that values must be unity. Then we say that is a orthonormal set. Then orthonormal set is a orthonormal basis because it's a non-zero vector. Okay. Apply Gram's committed orthogonal process. This problem they given in one of the question paper to the basis B is equal to 1, 0, 1, 1, 0, minus 1, 0, 3, 4 of the inner product space of Euclidean space with dimension 3 to find an orthonormal basis of Euclidean space with the dimension 3. They are given in the form of rho. First, we had to find as usual vectors v1, v2, v3 are the corresponding vectors of x1, x2, x3. You know how to find out using Gram's committed process. I have written the formula for v1, v2, v3. V1 is nothing but x1 itself. But while finding v2, first you find out what x2 comma v1. While finding x2 comma v1 is a row, therefore what we are going to write? X2 dot is, this is nothing but, what about, I want to find out this value. X2 comma, inner product of x2 comma v1 is what actually? Actually by mistake I written x1, actually it's not x1 actually. This is x2. I think it's clear for this part. Yeah. X2 dot V1. X2 dot V1 means what is X2? You know that X2 value they given in the problem. 1, 0, minus 1 dot V1. Just now we know that what is V1. What is V1 here? 1, 0, 1. 1 into 1 plus 0 into 1 minus 1 into 1. 1 plus minus 1, 0. Then you find out inner product of V1 comma V1. What is inner product of V1 comma V1? Is 1 square plus 0 square plus 1 square, what we get? 2. Now v2 is nothing but x2. X2 is, just now we know that what is my x2 is 0, 1, 0, minus 1, minus, this is 0 actually, therefore enter this term is 0, therefore x2 itself is nothing but v2 because inner product of x2 comma v1 is 0. Next, I have to find out V2. What are the values I want to find out first? X3 comma V1. X3 comma V1 is nothing but X3 dot V1. What is X3 they are given? 0, 3, 4 dot V1. 1, 0, 1. Multiply that, we get 4. Similarly, I to X3, inner product of X3 V2 is nothing but X3 dot V2. X3 is 0, 3, 4 dot. What about V2 is nothing but 1, 0, 1. Therefore, 0. 0 plus into minus minus 4. I think it's clear this part. In the next step, I have to find out inner product of which value? V2 comma V2. Because I want to find out V3. V2 is 1, 0, minus 1 dot 1, 0, minus 1. What do we get? 2. Then I have to substitute these values in V3. V3 is nothing but X3, 0, 3, 4 minus inner product of x3 comma v1 is 4 divided by inner product of v1 comma v1 is 2. We already calculated in the previous sheet. Into v1, 1, 0, 1 minus of inner product of x3 comma v2 is minus 4 divided by inner product of v2 comma v2 is, just now we calculated 2 into v2, 1, 0, minus 1. Simplify that. This is the value we get. V1, V2, V3 we get in the row vector. Then we have to verify the orthogonal vector means inner product of V1, V2, I to calculate, V2, V3 calculate, V1, V3 calculate. Definitely all are 0. Then we say that V1, V2, V3 are orthogonal and also non-zero vectors. Thus, these vectors is a non-zero orthogonal set. You know that whenever they're having orthogonal set, is a basis for the corresponding Euclidean space. Therefore, it's an orthogonal set for a subspace of B. We know that non-zero orthogonal set is a basis. Hence, the set V1, V2, V3 is an orthogonal basis for the subspace B of Euclidean space with dimension 3. Further, I want to verify orthonormal basis. Therefore, we have to find out normalized vector. V1 divided by norm of V1, V2 divided by norm of V2, V3 divided by norm. I already explained in my first video how to find norm. Square root of length of that. Square of what about V1, V2, V3. 1 square, 0 square plus 1 square. Now we get 2. Similarly, calculate norm of V2, 1 square, 0 minus 1 whole square, again root 2. I have to calculate this root of 9 is 3. Now we have to take U1, U2, U3. This is my U1. This is my U2 because I to multiplied by what? 1 by root 2 multiplied by 1 by root 2 multiplied by 1 by 3. We get this. And then you find out inner product of U1, U2, U1, U3, U1, U1, U2, U1, U3, U1, U2, U3. Now all are 0, then we say that U1, U2, U3 are orthogonal set. But the inner product to itself, U1 comma U1 must be 1, U2 comma U2 is must be 1, U3 comma U3 must be equal to 1. That means inner product of UI comma UJ equal to 0 for I is not equal to J, equal to 1 for I is equal to J. Then only say that these vectors are orthonormal set. Therefore, these U1, U2, U3 are orthonormal set. The corresponding is form a basis, therefore we treated U1, U2, U3 is an orthonormal basis for the subspace B of R3. Now it is enough to show that you already told orthonormal, it is enough to show that it is an orthonormal set. It is an orthonormal set, therefore it is an orthonormal basis for the subspace B of R3. Now I completed totally 4 problems. I am not considered what are the problems I discuss in my hard copy notes and also question paper except this problem, 4th problem. The rest of the problem you please work it out in assignment. The method is same. I think everyone is clear. Before going to wind up that class, I'm going to repeat the recall. Using Gram's committed process, you have to remember the formula for Vn in terms of Xn. Then for how many vectors you have, same based on that we get corresponding that much vectors from the Gram's committed process. Once we get the vector, you verify that whether the mutual vectors are inner product value must be 0. Then we say that that's an orthogonal set. Suppose the all vectors are non-zero, then we say that it's a non-zero orthogonal set of the given subspace of the Euclidean space. After then, from one of the result, whenever the non-zero orthogonal set is a basis, therefore the vector V1, V2, V3 are nothing but orthogonal basis for the subspace of Euclidean space. If you want to find out orthonormal basis, you have to move further from V1, V2, V3. You have to find out U1, U2, U3. How to find out U1? V1 divided by norm of V1. U2 is nothing but V2 divided by norm of V2. And then V3 is nothing but V3 divided by norm of V3. Now that is, you have to do the normalize. Once you normalize, you find out inner product of U1, U2, U2, U3, U1, U3. And also find out inner product of U1 comma U1, U2 comma U2, U3 comma U3 means inner product of UI UJ equal to 0 for I is not equal to J, equal to 1 for I is equal to J. Then only say that UI UJ is a orthonormal set. Therefore, then we say that is orthonormal set is clearly is orthonormal basis for the corresponding subspace of the Euclidean space. Thank you very much for listening my talk. If you have any doubt, free to ask the question where in the WhatsApp. Thank you. Bye. Take care. Only one concept is remaining is a QR factorization method. Once you complete that, I'm going to complete module 4. But please be serious, work hard, you take very seriously. Please complete day by day what are the video I'm going to upload. Yeah, thank you very much. Bye. Take care.